Okay, I have peeled back the lateral roots. As you can see, I don't know, is that good or... So I've peeled back the lateral roots. You can see that is the primary root system. Right there is where the seed was actually, that's actually where the seed, where it sprouted out of the seed. And you can see how woody and fleshy it is. And see how it goes right, it goes right into the center of the plant. That's what feeds the top. That's what feeds the milo head. So that's what you look for. If anybody wants to troll me, if any farmer out there is watching this, and if you want to see if the chemtrails that they have admitted have aluminum in them, and these are examples of heavy metal toxicity, if you want, just go check for yourself. If your plant's loosely rooted in the ground, you can easily pull it up, and the primary root system has turned red. This is a chemical burn.
Is that not where the seed comes out right
yeah.
here?
Yeah, right there where that bug is where the seed comes out. There's where it sprouts. We'll find one with seed in it.
Yeah.
Still on it in a minute, but okay, we're gonna go out here and pull another plant, and then I'm gonna show you the moisture levels that we have right now. Okay, I was kind of wanting to, we've had some fairly good rain in the last month or so, but there's good moisture there. There's good moisture if that primary root system could get down to it, but it can't because it's stunted. Here's the lateral roots right here that are trying to run laterally, but lateral roots were never designed to feed the plant. They're for storage, and they take up a little moisture, but they were never designed to supply moisture to the very growing tip of the plant. Again, that's why you see the tips of your trees dying. It's because the growing tip of that plant has been affected by something. Okay, so we've determined that this guy, he plowed his ground. He got his ground ready in time. He bought his seed. His timing was right. And it's hard to do as a farmer. A lot of times you don't hit it right like that. But he got it right. He got his seed up. And now if they wasn't chemtrailing us and putting heavy metals on this crop, that primary root system would start drilling down into this moisture right now. And there's more than enough moisture to sustain this crop for a good long time. But without the primary root system, and again, I'm going to cut some, but I'm trying to get more of that. I want to try to find one with the seed still on it so that you can tell. Well, see, it looks like that one has been burned off too. But again, we've got that primary root system is. Oh wait, let me see where. Oh, here it is. I missed it. There it is. Now that's a little better example of the primary root system. And see, right here is the primary root system of this milo plant, and it's woody, it's fleshy, And it's so normally this would could drill down at least 10 feet deep. This is why the Mississippi's flooding. This is why California is flooding. This is why you're having all the mudslides, is because the plants transpo-evaporate moisture. They uptake moisture and they put it back into the atmosphere, and that's what creates our rain. It's not the military. It's Mother Nature. But they are, this is with every plant. You cannot escape this root damage. It's not just with milo. Here, I'll pull a weed. Let me see. Let me go get a weed. It is June the 21st of 2012, and I have never seen this. This is I call it a careless weed. That's a male plant, and these plants usually make seed when in the fall, in October, when all the other annuals that are when the sun is less than 12 hours, I think. When the sun's less than 12 hours, these are the plants that start making seed. And this is a female plant of the same thing. I've never seen this before at this time of year. I think that's pretty wild. That's a massive find to me.